Hey guys, how's it going? And welcome back to another video. Today in this tutorial, we're gonna be rounding out our, series on particle effects in DaVinci Resolve. Now, when we started this series, we started with a simple sort of Thanos snap particle dissolve using text. Then we migrated over to images. And now in this tutorial, we're gonna show you how to do it with video footage of yourself that you can film anywhere, basically. So we're gonna cover that. Let's just quickly roll the clip of the effect we're gonna create. So you can sort of see how it works. Now, with this particular shot, we're gonna keep it pretty simple. Nice static camera, no camera moves. We can add those moves in post, all right? And before we get started on the actual tutorial on how to do it all in DaVinci Resolve, we need to sort of cover up the filming process, because to get this to work, you are gonna wanna film it a particular way. What you're gonna wanna do is have your camera on a tripod, nice and locked off, so the camera's not gonna move, otherwise we're gonna have to do tracking, and look, we don't really wanna do that. You're also gonna wanna have the camera in manual focus and have it focused on yourself. Now, if you need someone to help you, or if you just need to sort of, you know, figure it out, have it focus on yourself so that the background is blurry. We don't want that background to snap in and out of focus. All right, now it's really simple. Basically, you're gonna film, you're gonna hit record, right in front of the camera, gonna do whatever acting you wanna do. I did this sort of like head roll thing, whatever. Do whatever you wanna do, make it fun. And then you're gonna run off camera and you're gonna let it film for a little bit. Now it's important you wanna have a, what we call a clean plate. So just an empty frame without you in it, because we're gonna utilize that in this effect. Pretty easy to do in terms of filming. You do not need a green screen. A green screen would make this simpler, but I assume that the majority of you out there don't actually have a green screen, so we're gonna do it without it. So that's how you do it. Now, we're gonna jump into DaVinci Resolve and show you how to create the effect. Now, luckily, if you followed this sort of series, I guess, a lot of the effects are the same. Creating the particle systems the same and having it dissolve in and out, all that is the exact same for this tutorial. The only difference is you're gonna use it with the footage of yourself. And so, you know, manipulating that at the start there is gonna be a little bit different. Now, I'll also have chapter markers in the description below so you can sort of jump ahead to different sections. So if you only wanna learn how to cut footage of yourself out, there'll be a chapter for that. And yeah, links in the description if you wanna skip ahead to different parts of the video. Let's jump into DaVinci Resolve and show you how to create this awesome effect. All right guys, so here we are in DaVinci Resolve. We've just opened a standard project, and what we're gonna do is we're gonna grab our footage that we were looking at earlier, and we're gonna drag that down onto the timeline. Now, for the sake of this video, I don't actually need the audio, so I'm gonna get rid of that. And we've got the shot here, and so what we're gonna do is I'm just going to take a little bit from here, so we don't need that at the start. And I'm going to basically move this clip up until here. So that's the dissolve part. So we don't need anything else after that. What we do want with this clip though, is we're going to command R, and we're going to add a freeze frame on the part of the footage where there's no one there. So I walk off, now we want a freeze frame. So command R, drop down and freeze frame. It's gonna give you this little red area. And what we're gonna do is we're just going to extend it quite a bit, B at the back end here, and then command B here. We're just gonna delete that little bit there. We don't need it, all right? And then what we're gonna do is drag our video footage onto the second layer of us doing whatever we're doing. And then the, what we call the clean plate underneath. And then you can retime it there. So now we've got two bits of footage. All we wanna do now with the playhead over and with them both selected, we're gonna right click and go new fusion clip. Gonna bring them together, and then we're gonna go to fusion. Perfect, and now we have our sort of node tree here. Let's get rid of that. So what we wanna do is let's rename the footage. So ideally, if you did it the exact way I said, the background will be our clean plate and the foreground will be the acting video that we did. So we can rename these and we can just say acting or whatever you wanna call it, and then rename the clean plate, because that's what we want to call it, clean plate. Awesome. Now, what we want to do is we can get rid of this merge. All right, so with our acting plate in here, what we're going to do is we're going to mask out ourselves, basically, so that we are independent to the background. Now, I was playing around with this. In a real VFX workflow, you would want to rotoscope this. So frame by frame, animate a mask right around the outline and make it as perfect as you can. However, with the effect we're going to create, we don't really need to do that. So what we're going to do is we're going to move to the very first frame of this. We're going to click the polygon tool with our node selected. And now we can't see anything. What I want you to do is just click a random shape roughly around where the character would be, all right, until we get what we want. And then we're going to start adding points to this. All right, now, like I said, it doesn't have to be exact. So what we're going to do is we're going to leave a little border, not a big border, but just a little border around ourselves. Now, it's important that the border is as minimal as we can make it, simply because we're going to be using this to generate the particles. Now, because we're going to have the clean plate in the background, it's not going to make too much difference if there are some particles that are a different color, because we'll have that clean plate. So anyway, let's just quickly create this shape. Now, the reason we do this at the start of the animation, so by moving down to frame zero, is when you create a polygon, it automatically keyframes the position of all the points. And so it's just easier to do this right at the start. All right, so there's no confusion. Now, you do want to bring it in pretty close, and that should be fine. Now, what we're going to do now is quickly animate this mask so that it takes the shape, and we get this nice little border the entire animation. So we're going to move right to the very end, and we don't really need to do anything, which is good. We're going to move to the middle of the animation, and basically, we're just going to click through and make sure that we don't need to animate that mask at all. We might need to, nope, looks pretty good the whole way through. However, if you did need to, you could just move forward and move it, and the mask will, you can see here, move into place as you animate. Cool. So now that we have that, we're going to use this to control our particle system. So let's create our particle system like before. So we're gonna drag in our emitter and our renderer, and we're just going to link them together. Now, with the P renderer selected, we'll go to our inspector. We want to change the output mode to 2D. So it's a 2D particle scene. And if we have this open, we can place our acting one here, and let's put the particle render over here. And you can see we got this nice selection of particles. Now, with the P emitter selected, we want to go to region. And we want to change the region from sphere to bitmap, which gives us this little input and allows us to connect our acting thing into the P emitter input. Now, you can't really see anything at the moment because there's only, I think, 10 particles by default. But if we were to increase this to like 1,000 particles, now you can kind of see the shape of our person, ourselves. And we can also go, you change the color from style color to color from region, and then you get like a much better interpretation. In fact, if we were to go to say 4,000, give it a sec, you can see now we have our thing and the particles kind of generate and all that sort of stuff. So yeah, like it works for what it needs to be for now. Is now we can also, if we want to, let's just go to the emitter, and we're gonna just change that to 500 while we're working because we don't want to be too intense. We're gonna add our forces. So with the P emitter selected, we're gonna shift space and type in P directional force. And all we're gonna do is change the direction from minus 90 to 45 degrees. It's gonna make all the particles shoot up in this direction. Can't quite see it at the moment. And again, with that selected, shift space, we're gonna type in PT, and we're gonna type in P turbulence. And the effects I find best is we're gonna change all of them to 0.2, and then we're gonna change the density to 35. Those are the best settings that I've found to get that nice sort of wispy particle goodness. So now we've got all that done, we're just gonna open this. We now need to create a mask that is going to control where the particles are coming from, because we don't want all the particles coming out at once. So to do that, we're just going to open another viewer, and we're going to just create a normal polygon, okay? And this polygon, we're just going to create, let's just do it from top down, and we're just gonna do around here, like so, and it doesn't have to be perfect, just a shape like that. Okay, and we can see it over here. So nothing spectacular. What we're gonna do then is we're gonna Control C or Command C that polygon and Command Shift V. We're going to what's called pasting an instance of that. So basically duplicating it. And what this basically means is the instance shares the exact same parameters. So if I adjust the parameters on one, you can see it adjusts it there. So what we want to do is we want to de-instance, so with this instance polygon selected, right click on border width, I'm gonna go de-instance. So that allows us to adjust the border width of one of them without it affecting the other. It's complicated. Let's move a merge node down. Okay, and we're gonna merge these two together. So we're gonna drag one of them to the background and one of them to the foreground. Play the merge there. Now we do need to change some settings in the merge node. We're gonna change the operator from over to XOR. If we uncheck solid, now we can grow our border. And we're just gonna make it a bit softer as well. Something like that. Not too soft, just a little soft. Looking good. Okay, what we wanna do now is we're gonna convert this into a bitmap image. So we're gonna, with nothing selected, shift space and type bitmap, hit enter. And we're going to drag that merge into the input. So the yellow triangle, perfect. And now all we need to do is we're going to create a map controller, shift space, M-A-T-T-E, map controller. Perfect. So we're going to drag and drop that in between our acting media node and the peer emitter by just with the node selected, holding shift until the lines go colored and drop it. Perfect. And we're going to drag the bitmap into the garbage mat, which is this bottom right triangle here. Can't really see anything. What we're going to do is with the mat control selected, we're going to go to garbage mat. I'm going to invert that and give it a sec to load. Now you can see we're getting some particles. Perfect. We can probably increase this now to like maybe a 1500. Perfect, perfect, perfect. All right. What we can do now is with the polygons is we can actually at the start. So what we're going to do is we're going to have this and we're going to move it up so it's out of the way. And then we're going to go to the very end of the frame and we're going to have this fully engulf the actor. Okay. So like so, let our P render do its thing for a little bit. It's always got to load every time you adjust a parameter. And now you can sort of see some leftover particles. If we go halfway through this animation, there we go. We got some particles. Now there are some white ones there. That's okay. We won't notice it too much. It'll look pretty good. So we're going to go to the P emitter again. And what we're going to do is go to style. And instead of the apply mode to add, we're just going to go merge. Okay. So the add, basically every time a particle of color goes over one another, it kind of adds the color together and makes this weird glowing effect. Merge just allows the particles to, you know, react together, which is good. All right. So let's start to finish this off. So we're going to drag our P render to our media out. We're going to drag our clean plate into the background there by putting it in the background. Now we have the particles sort of coming off and now you can see how, because the particles around the edge of myself were the same color as the background, you don't really notice them as much. So that works out well. And then what we're gonna do is just grab the original footage that we created, our little bit over here. We're gonna Command C, copy that and paste it over here, okay? We're gonna merge it on top. So let's just chuck the merge. Looking good so far. And then all we wanna do is copy the polygon over here, paste it. We're going to drag it to the mask of the merge and we're just gonna change it to a solid mask and we're gonna invert it. And so now if we play this back, see the particles come through and dissolve us from there. So obviously we kind of got the timing wrong a bit there, but yeah, looks pretty, pretty good. All right guys, there you have it. That is how you make yourself dissolve. Fly away as if Thanos himself had snapped you out of existence in DaVinci Resolve 17. Pretty easy. There will be a playlist on my channel where I have all the particle effects tutorials, I guess, bundled together if you want to watch them all at once. If you enjoyed this video, make sure you hit that thumbs up button and subscribe to the channel for more content like this. And yeah, I guess I'll see you guys in the next video.